Also, the dress and the covering must be loose. There are dresses that, yes, they cover the body, but they show the entire body in its forms and everything. That is not the Muslim, that's not the dress of a Muslim woman that fears Allah and has the dignity of Islam. That's not the case. And so we should advise our daughters and our peers, our sisters, of this. This is very important. It's the covering of all what needs to be covered, and it is the looseness of the dress. It should not, subhanAllah, sometimes, you know, your heart bleeds. You go to masajid, and you see sisters dressed in fashions that are not fit for Islam, let alone fit for a masjid at the time of Jumu'ah. And yet they come and pray Jumu'ah. This is disastrous. We should not do these things. This becomes the area of al-amr bil ma'roof. It is the area that will befall on all of us to advise with that which is ma'roof, that which is good, and stop that which is not good and which is not acceptable. Even by the word of mouth. Pull the sister down, and probably sister to sister is the best vehicle for such a thing. Now that you know this, work on your sister in the most beautiful manner. No harshness, no enmity, nothing. It is just a reminder, and you start with yourself, that I am correcting myself and invite you to join me in correcting ourselves. That's how the invitation should be. It is not by dragging people out of masajid. That's not the way. Also, prohibited is, practice of making tattoos and all of that. Tattooing is prohibited in Islam. Anything that leaves a lasting mark that cannot be removed except by painful surgery, that is haram. Because it is this body that Allah has given you, and you must preserve it. You are not to alter it in one shape or another. Undergoing surgery to change what Allah has given as your look is haram. Muslim is not supposed to do that. Also, subhanAllah, items that are indicative of luxury living is haram. Or paganism is also haram. For example, gold and silver utensils, statues to be kept at home, or to be hung somewhere in your car, those are haram because they remind of the people who lived with arrogance. Why does a human being need a golden plate to eat or a golden spoon to eat with? Is it out of necessity? Is it out of, what is it? It's only arrogance and the show of arrogance. And Allah prohibits the arrogant behavior. If you recall, we mentioned, I believe, in one of these sessions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us not to walk on earth with arrogance, because you shall not pierce the earth, nor shall you reach the mountains in height, in tallness. So you are what you are, and there is no need. And also, those who in history have used silver and gold to eat as utensils or spoons or forks and so forth, really, they have acquired that through the transgression against others. If there is somebody who is using a golden spoon as a king, or it must be thousands of people who have suffered for that king to obtain the luxury life that he is living. There is no need for this. Islam teaches us to be modest and to live by observing Allah's orders. The use of statues also is prohibited. If we were to buy a statue of something and put it in our house, that is haram. We are not supposed to do that. But of course, forms, three-dimensional forms, we find them today in toys, children toys. That's not haram. Children's toys are not haram. They are an exception. Because the the intention of them is not any form of worship or anything like that, or creation, or claiming that you can create something that Allah is of really Allah's creation. There's no intent in that. So toys are halal. Also painting, and to a certain extent photography. There is no general ruling on this. The scholars don't have a general ruling. Each case is judged individually, depending on what is depicted in the painting. For example, a painting known to be related to items of worship by people, you should not hang that painting in your house, that's haram. Or painting that exhibits the creatures of Allah, for example, birds and living things, and the forms and the beauty of that, that's the realm of Allah. The artist is not to create that. There are other forms of art rather than paintings that depict those things. A classical one is the picture of what is claimed to be Isa alayhi salam, Jesus alayhi salam. You don't hang that in your house as a Muslim, because it means what it means to a Christian. Christian doesn't hang that painting or that form because it's just a form. It's a form of his Lord according to his mind. And so that is haram. Or a statue that is, in fact, all statues, not just the that have religious implications. Work and earning. What is halal and what is haram in this area of work and earning? Of course, we know there is an Islamic obligation to work and earn a living. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, charity is halal neither for a rich nor for able-bodied. So somebody who is rich, who has what he needs, cannot go and beg, is not deserving of charity. We should not give charity to somebody like that. Somebody who is able to work does not qualify to receive charity. This is all to discourage people from adopting attitude of not working. People have to be encouraged to work and earn a respectful living. It is haram to beg from others without dire necessity. Really, asking and begging from others is only under dire conditions. It should not be the norm of life. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam said in another hadith, he who begs without a need is like a person who holds a burning coal in his hands. So burning coal, you cannot tolerate it. You cannot handle it for a very, very short moment. That's how that thing that falls on your hand by the activity of begging, it's like a hot coal that's hard to hold. So Muslims should not beg. The practice of begging is not decent for a Muslim who is able to earn a living. Of course, work is dignified in Islam. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam said in this famous hadith, it is better that a person should take a rope and bring a bundle of wood on his back to sell so that Allah may preserve his honor, than he should beg from people whether they give to him or refuse him. So Rasulullah ﷺ is giving us the most rudimentary method of earning a living. What is it? A rope that one takes to the forest. Go collect wood that people need. He brings that bunch of wood and he sells it. And he earns something out of that. That is better than begging. And so, which means here, there is no work that is not honorable. There is no work that is not dignified. Every work is dignified in the realm of halal, of course. Every work, there is no lower job or higher job.